Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to take a look at our Raspberry Pi and seeing how we can set up a DNS server. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me, and please do, at The Urban Penguin. And on Facebook, you'll be able to find and like my page as The Urban Penguin. So we'll be working at the command line of our Raspberry Pi machine with an SSH connection, and you can see that I've got root privileges. The first thing that we're going to do is then check for our bind or Barclay internet name daemon surface. If we just do our normal apt cache and search, you can see there's an awful lot of utilities that has the string bind in it. So we might prefer to do an apt cache and then pkg names. So this way we're looking for names that start with bind. So now we've got a much easier search to work with. The service that we want is bind 9. So if we look then at apt get install and bind 9 and see what this brings. Now if we look, it's going to install then bind 9 and bind 9 utils, but it's also suggesting DNS utils, bind 9 docs, resolve conf, and UFW. We don't really need resolveconf or UFW, but we might put the DNS utils, we might use those, and then the bind 9 documentation might work for us. So let's just not continue. So we chose no, and then go back and do an apt get install bind 9 DNS utils, and then the bind 9 dash doc. So what we're just looking at is better ways perhaps to manage our installations, and by looking at the output rather than just choosing yes. So with this now, let's go ahead and run the install. And of course, we'll continue with this. Now we can see now the name service is starting bind 9. So we should be up and running with this straight away. It will work by default as a caching only service. So if I check bind 9 and run the status, so it is up and running. The configuration on the Raspbian operating system is all kept in etc bind. So let's go into that directory, so cd /etc/bind. And if we do a listing of this directory, we can see then that we have both the zone files, the database files, the configuration, the name.conf, as well as then some additional include files. So if we look, we've got name.conf default zone, name.conf local, name.conf.options. If we go through and have a look in the ordinary name.conf, it does nothing but include the .options, the .local, and the .default zones. So it's just that they are breaking up the configuration rather than just maybe have one big configuration. So we'll need to look in these separate files to see the configuration of our server. So let's open up now name.conf.defaultzones. So this is like our main configuration where we're loading the hints, the root zone servers, and then our reverse lookup zone and the local host zone. And then if we go through and look in the options file, this is where we specify the directory. So we can see then if we just specify relative paths, we're going to be looking in the directory /var/cache/bind. Again, there are other options that can be set here. So we've got DNSX validation set to auto, and then the listening addresses. If we look in that directory, var, cache, and bind, we see we don't have a lot in there, so the key file and a journal. Now, of course, the DNS server, as we saw before, was up and running. So if I make a change through to my etc and resolve.conf, we would be able to query the service. So again, if we double check, the status is up and running, but if we want to see more detail on the status, we can use RNDC and status. So this is the actual bind service itself. So we get a little bit more detail coming back. But if I now go through and edit my etc and resolve.conf and point through to the local server, we'll be able to test that I can resolve and I'm acting as a caching only server. So I have no database records other than the root zone servers, but that is all that I really need. So if I go through and put the search, so we're going to use a zone later, tup.com, and then we can put name server 127.0.0.1. So I'm going to try the local name server first. If we can't resolve from that, we can then go through and check my ISP server. So let's now go through and check with the dig command, diglabs.theurbanpenguin.com. So this is an internet-based DNS record, and we can see that we've been able to resolve it. And when we check the server record towards the bottom, we can see then that it was resolved from the local server, 127.0.0.1. So it's very simple to get a caching-only DNS server up and running. We should also check that it is enabled for system startup. So on Debian-based systems, we can run an update rc.d by 9 and just set it to the defaults. So it will be configured then to start when the system boots. So we need now to edit the local file to put in a record for our own zone. So if we go through and edit name.conf.local, remember this was included in the name.conf. There's not much in here. But if we go down to the bottom of the file, so we can use capital G and then O to insert a new line, and we create a zone definition, put in the zone name, so this is going to be tup.com, and then in our braces we define the zone, and don't forget to put a semicolon after the closing brace bracket. So the type of the zone is going to be the master, so this is a read-write record. And the file, we're going to keep the way that is done on this Debian system by putting the files in etc bind. So we specified the full path. Had we specified a relative path, it would be in or relative to the directory directive. And that's going to be pointing through to var cache bind. So as we've gone through now, we've put the entry in pointing through to our tup.zone. And if we take a look at that file, I've already created that file. So let's just use cat and have a look at the contents of the file. So remember, we're pointing through to tup.zone. So we start off with our default time to live of 2 hours. So it's specified in seconds, but then that's just shown as 2 hours. We then have our start of authority record. We have a name server record that's pointing through to pi.tup.com. And then we have entries for Pi, Pixie, VMware, Store, and Gateway. So we can now keep our name server running, but just reload the zone. So tup.com, so we specify then the name of the DNS zone, reread the information in, and then we can check the log file to see that the name server has carried out those tasks and haven't come across any errors. And on Debian, that's var log and syslog. So we can see then we've loaded the serial number, and we can see then that we've not had any problem accessing the zone. We should now then be able to resolve name records, and we can do that using the dig command. So dig gateway, that was one of the records. We can see then that's coming in as the 01 machine. And again, we're getting that from the name server that we see. Again, we can go in and try one of the other records. So let's say like pixie.tup.com. And we can see then again, we're getting the record of .04 for that. So hopefully this has given you some ideas of setting up the name daemon on Raspberry Pi.